But when you look at your body, when you look at the world, it seems that you are engaged with everything, that you have no time for God. But every night, He dissolves your body in the subconscious sphere and makes you realize that you are not a man nor a woman, but a piece of consciousness, a reflection of His consciousness sleeping in space, in joy. The drama of sleep gave me the greatest faith in God. When anybody told me I am made in the image of God, I laughed. Because I couldn't see in this frail body the image of God. But Master said, in this subconscious mirror of sleep, you find that you are infinite. That every night you become the infinite. You are not man nor woman. You are joyous and happy and conscious. For when you wake up, you always know that you were never unconscious in sleep. You exactly know how you sleep. Only you are not conscious of your body. But you are conscious of your real self. And the nest of your troubles starts with the body. So all the gifts and kindness that you have given to me, I want to give this gift to you. Remember these two natures in you. The nature as a man, as a human being during the day, and the nature as God at night. As I often say, we are all gods at night, but we become devils during the day. And if we can be gods during the day, we are gods all the time. And this purpose of life must not be drowned in the various engagements with matter. We must remember, if God says, I have no time for you, and stops sticking in your heart, all your engagements have to be cancelled immediately. For one of the great sayings in India is, he is the cleverest who finds God. He is the cleverest who gives time to find God. He is the cleverest who finds that supreme happiness within. And you can stand unshaken amidst the crash of breaking worlds. He whose peace, the riches of peace, cannot be taken away by all the robbers of circumstances and trials. So in this spiritual family, you all remind me by your actions of one whom millions forget. And that's why they suffer. I remember one day I was in the movies. Movies has one fascination, because I see the whole world as movies.